David Banzino, physician, scientist, searching for a way to tap into the hidden strengths that most people have. An accidental overdose of gamma radiation alters his body chemistry. And now, when David Banzino grows angry or outraged, a startling metamorphosis occurs. The creature is driven by rage and pursued by an investigative reporter.
Mr. Mahagi, don't make me to be angry. You don't gonna like if I'm gonna be angry.
The creature is wanted for the murder of Vinny Magalesh. David Banzino is also believed to be dead, and he must let the world think that he is dead until he can find a way to control the raging spirit that dwells within him.
Porra! Welcome to another exciting, beautiful episode of the Renato Laranja Show with Renato Laranja. Porra! I'm Renato Laranja. Today we're gonna do a lot of stuff. We're gonna reminisce about a lot of old stuff from the past, and we're gonna get also to the future and also on the present. The past is history, the future is mysteries, and now is the time and have big presents. So we're gonna find some old friend. We're gonna talk about some women that I've been with and that maybe I'm gonna be seeing in the future. And then also we're gonna have talk about some stuff that I'm not, don't really wanna talk about so much. That's kids. So sit back, strap your seat, put on your black belts, and let's get ready to humble. Porra, caralho!
This way, exit.
Exit this way. That way. But I came from that way, so I'm gonna go to the other side. Welcome back. Today, I have a special treat for you and for all you ladies out there. This is a guy that's I've known since he was a little guy when he used to pee the bath and stuff like that. He was afraid and he didn't want nobody to hurt the guy when he was did jiu-jitsu. But now he's all big and grown up and he's the crown prince royalty of the Grace family. And it's an honor for him to be on the show, for him to have to be here today. That's my Broginho, Hannah Gracie. Porra! Campeão!
What's up, man?
You're using that stuff. Let me direct you to your seat over there. Don't break the stuff here. Boy, you're not used to this kind of stuff. Yeah.
How are you, man?
I'm good, my brother. You became strong.
Is this broken?
No, that's just a nice, we call that vintage chair. Oh, you're gonna put it so you don't look small next to me.
I'm 6'4", homie.
Okay, but I'm homie. You've been hanging that African-American guy's, Kevin, what's the guy's name?
Team Kevin.
You like homie, it, yes. That case. You see that book of knowledge I was trying to help you out. But sometimes these kids, they know everything. You can't teach them anything. They know all that stuff. Boy, never mind that. You got some water here.
Thank you.
Yeah, because I know that you like to treat yourself good. You like to be healthy.
Try to take care of myself. You know how it is.
I do know how that is. And I know that you, like me, you have a taste for Puerto Rican women.
Yes, my fiance is of Nicaraguan descent. Eve?
Hey, careful you said that because she's black.
No.
You said she's what?
Nicaraguan.
Nicaragua. Oh, because she's a Nicará. I thought you said she's
Nicaragua. Listen, bro. Nicaraguan and German. She's beautiful. She's wonderful. She's beautiful. Intelligent.
She's a diva.
And she does jiu-jitsu. She did wrestle.
She did. She don't did that no more.
No more. Now only jiu-jitsu.
You don't want to be around that guy. That big black guy's Booker Chi.
Yes.
Yeah, the Harlem Heat. You don't know what kind of heat that guy's packed. Okay, poor. Look at that. Yeah, look, so can you believe how far? Can you believe how far?
Congratulations on the show. This is very cool. And
we're here.
I remember the beginning.
Yeah, we start from the garage, and now we're here.
We made it.
Poha. You know, I've spent a lot of time with you, you know, the old days. And I can't believe all the stuff. You know, I remember when we used to play games, and you was a little scared to fight the other kids. And I was always help you. I'm glad that you didn't turn out like I thought you was gonna turn out. You're a strong guy, okay? Your other brother, that little one, he was invent Metamucil.
Metamorris.
Meh.
The little brother. He's not little, he's big.
Oh, that guy. But he have little freckles and stuff.
Lots of
like
freckles.
That.
His freckles are part of the family.
That's part of that tradition.
It's part of the family. It's what happens when you have a father as dark as our father, and a mom as white as our mom, and the freckles come through.
I too like white women. Yeah, poor.
Yeah.
So
yes.
I
did the Metamorris.
I get off the subject. I digest.
Yes.
Or you say, but I digest.
Yes.
Okay, and then so
digress.
So what? What?
Digress.
Digress. Poha, I've had such a good time with you, I don't even got to the question. I got some questions. You're on the hot seat, my brother. We're gonna pretend, we're gonna do like a heel stuff here. Okay?
Beautiful
so
guy.
Now you, I remember also from the old days, now the guy, that old guy who is on Modern Family, the guy was Ted Bundy.
Ed O'Neill.
Ted Bundy, the guy who scored 7 touchdowns on the same game or something like that.
His name is Ed O'Neill, his real name.
Okay.
Al Bundy is the character he played on Married with Children.
I thought Ed O'Neill was the guy who played Superfly.
No.
Okay.
Ed O'Neill is the real name of an actor who played Al Bundy, and he scored 7 touchdowns.
Yeah, Hulk I high, remember that.
And he trains at the Gracie Academy. He's a black belt, very nice guy, great technique.
Okay.
He's like an uncle to me. I think he's known me since I was 10, 11 years old, and it's been amazing to
you know who has been an uncle? You got something, your nose that's done on there? Look at that.
Come on, man.
Remember I was did that to you a long time ago? He didn't know. The first time I did that to that guy, he thought I was took that nose for real on that one. And Poha, as long as we are doing a little trips down memory lane, I got a little surprise for you. A lot of people didn't know that when he was a kid, he always liked to play Star Wars. And your favorite character, remember your favorite character? It's Billy Dee Williams. And then he created the scene with Prince Leia, Princess, okay?
I didn't watch Star Wars when I was a kid.
Yeah, but the thing is, you watched when I did the puppet show like that.
Well, you low down dirty swindler. Well, you got a lot of nerve showing your face after what you pulled. Well, you a pirate? Well, hello, what have we here? You truly belong with us amongst the clouds. Hi, I'm Lando Calrissian. I'm the administrator of this facility.
But and when you was a kid, it had a lot of mystique to that one.
I don't remember this situation.
Okay. Hey, look, that's either here or there.
Hold on. Boy, yes.
We don't have to do that. Look.
You brought me to do an interview about jiu-jitsu, family, the legacy, the growth.
We got off topic. I told you that was not gonna play. Let's go back, okay? You wanna go back, you wanna talk serious stuff, okay? I remember when, let's go back. 1991, UFC 1.
93.
Okay, me, your father, a lot of other people, some Jewish guys, we created something. We created a plan, okay? A way to show that Gracie Jiu-Jitsu is gonna be the one. It's gonna show to the top.
This was the plan. And,
okay, I remember, and I'm gonna let you talk in a second. I'm gonna let you talk. I remember when they was trying to find somebody to represent jiu-jitsu. I was, everybody wanted, Ronya, you gotta have Renach. That's the only way. And a lot of people said, porra, you're gonna have Renach, everybody's gonna be like, that guy's physique, he looks like he's chiseled from Egyptian cinnamon. The guy looks like a Greek or some kind of god. And they're gonna not be impressed with that technique, so they pick someone who's more frail and have more straight hair. So they went to Royce, and he was represent.
Excuse me.
Oh, you're welcome.
So here's the thing. I was only 10, 11 years old when UFC 1 was launched. Mm. But I don't remember the story.
Yeah, a lot of people like to have selective memories. I'm glad that...
From what I remember, it was between Hickson and Royce, and they were saying the same thing that Hickson... They were saying the same thing that Hickson...
Well, how is that guy now?
Hickson's great, man. Surfing, traveling, teaching.
I don't see him so long.
But they chose Royce to do the UFC because Royce was one of the, you know, the smaller members of the family compared to Hickson, who everybody thought should go in and represent. But Hickson was too strong and too capable that it wouldn't be as impressive as a testament for Gracie Jiu-Jitsu.
No, go away, wait, don't stop. Everybody's listening to the thing. I'm just check a test. I can do two stuffs at the same time. I'm listening with you. You just said nobody knew, everybody thought Hickson was, and then Renach, what everybody liked, Renach Laranja. Okay, cut, chew, boom. Now go to from the past, gonna go to the future. Or the
we're going to right now.
No, in right now, we're gonna talk about something that was happening in the past, but from the UFC back then, it would be the future. So I don't know what time that is.
It's still the past, but the more recent past.
Okay, so they're gonna go to the more recent past. Metamorph, chew. Okay, let's talk about what happened to your friend Charles Schwab when he was... I know that nobody has asked you about this. Nobody want to talk about what
people
happened to Charles.
People have asked me about it, yeah.
People have asked you that.
You talking about Brandon Schwab?
That's his nickname, Brandon.
That's his real name.
Charles Schwab. Okay, so I don't know where you got... So I don't know where you got Charles Schwab.
No, I didn't say that. You said that.
Okay, a lot of people said that. So, Brandon Schwab's.
Brandon Schwab. There's no W.
What kind of name? That's Jewish?
I don't know, bro. It's...
Okay.
It's his family.
I don't know, bro. You're hanging out Kevin Case too much. You get... It's kind of tough. I see you have that black... That attitude. Hip-hop. All the guys like to do that.
I have a lot of white bros, too.
Okay. I got a lot of white bros and a lot of white other stuffs. Wait for me after this one. So let's not try to, you know, one-upmanships. Something else. You've grown to be a nice, great man. Now,
trying to perpetuate.
On to your sister, your younger sister.
What does she have to do with this?
We gotta keep moving along. How she's doing?
Sage?
Yeah.
Sage is amazing.
Sage.
Yeah, she's engaged, about to get married. She's wonderful.
She's about to get married?
Yeah.
Okay, enough about your sister. Kira Gracie, how she's doing?
Kira's amazing.
She's also wonderful. Very beautiful.
Also very beautiful,
can
no doubt.
Can tell that Gracie diet did a lot for her. She have a lot of energy.
The Gracie diet mixed with the jiu-jitsu lifestyle can do miracles for anyone.
Boy, I'd like to make some energy happen between her and me.
Yeah, I don't know if the energy is something that is really transferable outside of me. It's typically something that I have and I, you know, well, people say he has the energy. But for say someone else has the energy, no, you have.
I had not the G, whatever, like that. Boy. And a lot of girls has found the not the G, I found the G, some kind of G. You know what I'm saying to me?
Yeah.
Boy, you know about that stuff. Caralho. To see you now, something else. I remember when you shit yourself when you was a kid.
Here's the deal.
You remember when I used to call you Hen Shamrock and you used to cry and you call, it was Suzanne, mommy. Anyway.
I don't remember that.
Okay, anyway, go ahead.
Bullyproof, Gracie Bullyproof. We're teaching the parents how to work with the kids.
See, this, now you're talking my language because as a parent, if I was a parent and I wanna bully my kid, I'm gonna have to know what's legal. I can put my hands to him. I can either to do one of that or I can bite the trachea here, okay? I can send him to bed without to eat anything. I can do anything like that. So I wanna do a stuff. It's almost the same stuff, but it's called child support proof, because a lot of dads has been victimized. Okay, your thoughts?
Yeah, I just think you really don't understand what Gracie Bullyproof even is, and I don't even feel like trying to explain it.
We're gonna agree to disagree on that one. But here's the stuff. That's why I'm gonna do an expose. I'm gonna do an investigative report on that one.
Hi.
You also offer a lot of programming on there. You're teaching cops how to subdue black people. You're teaching, you know, a lot of the way of life, how to eat.
It has nothing to do with black people. We teach cops how to neutralize the threat, control the suspect, and arrest them without hurting them.
Yeah, that's
black, white, Mexicans, Egyptian, doesn't matter, anybody.
The suspect. So anyway. So we had a call when I used to do some bouncing. You have a lot of black guys come there. You have a lot of Puerto Rican, whatever you have. You go, boy, there's a lot of Canadians in here tonight. But it wasn't talk about a Canadian. It was talk about blacks. But the one I want to focus, okay, and the one a lot of guys have me and Hansel was discussed this. Why you have something called Empower to Women? I already have enough trouble with Honda Housey, with Saborg, with Misha Tate, always trying to defense themselves from me. Now I have all the other ones gonna do that same stuff?
Well, this is typically something that is used against a sexual predator, you know, assailant, someone with malicious intentions.
You say tomato, I say potatoes. It's 6 dozen of one, half of one of the other.
Well, you know, this Women in Power program is a serious thing. I don't know if you think it's serious or not, but we think that giving women the ability to defend themselves against...
Listen, Hannah, you know, I know that it's a serious subject, okay? And like I always said, you know, one on the hand is worth two on the bush.
Meaning what?
Let's go to a commercial.
Thank you.
Jorge. What I'm doing? I'm nothing. Just making oodles of monies on Couch Move Fantasy MMA. It's like fantasy football or fantasy other stuff. You're gonna get a team of five fighters. And then depending if they win, then you're gonna win some money. And then if they lose, then you're not gonna get nothing. You're gonna continue to be in the poorhouse. But what difference it makes to me? I'm already rich. Wow.
Now it's time for our topical quente. In English, it's hot topic. Hot topic. Women on MMA, go.
I think it's amazing. I think that,
It's amazing.
Yes. Women in MMA is amazing.
They
there's the stable of amazing female MMA competitors and martial artists out there is ridiculous around the world.
It is ridiculous.
And for it to finally
I believe
UFC,
the same stuff. Okay, now we're on the same page, my brother. It is ridiculous.
I think it's great, and I think that so they put on some of the best fights. I think since the first female UFC fight when Ronda went in there and did her thing and represented on that level.
Hold on.
MMA as a whole,
I have to cut in. You said that it was great. You meant it was great before they allowed that women, they allowed Ronda to be on the UFC.
No, I think it's great that Ronda's in the UFC and the rest of the girls as well. And I think they do some of the most entertaining fights in UFC history are female MMA fights. And since that's what they want is entertainment and they want something that the fans can fall in love with and root for, they haven't disappointed yet. And I get excited by every women's MMA fight because I know they're gonna deliver on the
highest
level.
I get excited too because I'm worried something's gonna happen to that one. That baby, that gachinho's in there and they get a black eye on there. They get a tooth, you're gonna chip the tooth and stuff like that. And then when they win, like a guy in the hair. They have the hair in the ponytail. But then on this part, let me tell you something. On this part, the little hairs, like Misha Tate, the little hairs come out there, don't lay, porra. And a little stuff's here. I'm sorry.
They're professional athletes. They're professional athletes.
Yeah, that's the professional. Can we cut this? Go on, I'm sorry. They're a professional athlete. What if one of these ladies, it turns out afterwards the lady is pregnant? One of these gals was got pregnant.
That's their choice, what do you mean?
What if they was in a fight and they pregnant they with child? God forbid that, if that was to happen.
Yeah, I would assume that they do medical checkups prior to make sure that they're not fighting pregnant, if that's what you're asking.
I hope to God that they do, okay? And it's shame on you. And Dana and that commish for that, because that's a part that I want to investigate. Except for if she's pregnant with my child, you have the option to do what you want to do because, you know, whatever. But I'm worried that women's safety. I love women, okay? I want to protect that women's. A lot of people say I'm sexist for that. Nobody is more feminist than me. I like women more than anybody, okay? That's why I don't want them to bruise. I don't bruise the goods, don't squeeze the charmins, they used to say. How many times you're gonna have somebody to pull out of a fight because their vagina has too much blood? And even after that, it was also have sometimes you wanna stay away from the, you don't wanna go down there because it's gonna smell like, it have a smell, it have a taste, it's tart. You know, when it's taste, it have like metallic.
Do you want me to reply to this?
Yeah, that's why I'm asking.
Next question.
I can't. I'm throwing you the hardball questions. There's no escape. You see, there's one way out. That's the window over there. And then there's one past my the hound on the Baskervilles over there. So,
What's the question?
The question is, what are you going to do? You can't That's the reason why you can't have a female president, because if they get cuckoo every time when they have the period and you want to send them somewhere for a little while. I like to have a woman have talent, but that kind of talent, I don't have any use for that. We didn't made, look, I'm a Christian, okay? I pray to my God. God was on the sixth day, he was made man. And then after that, and he taught man to fight and to jiu-jitsu. And then, and after that, he was said, well, man needs somebody to have sex or and also to talk to and to, you know, to hang out sometime. Then he made from, he gave him some ribs, and he was ate the ribs, and then he was satisfied. And I can't remember if she was made the ribs or if she was created to the rib. The point is that, my God, it's not Adam and Eve, it's Adam and Steve. It's not Adam and Eve, it's Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steve. Okay, so whatever they did, it's against my God. There you go. Hot topic. And by the way, I'm not happy about what I saw that Grace breakdown where you gave a shout to Eddie Bravo. And I told you that, yeah, imagine your father found out about that one. And imagine Hoyler's gonna be hauling over on his grave if he find that shit that you did that. I want you to take that one down.
What are you talking about?
You know what I'm talking about. I want you to take that one down. Boa! How you doing, my baby? Okay. Wow. We had a good time here.
Big time.
And at some time, you got this respectful and got a little out of line. And some time, I informed you, and it's been informative. It's been a couple of times it was even funny and exciting. And you're gonna gain a lot from this exposure on here. And I just wanna say thank you for being here, and also that, you know, it's a treat for you to experience to talk man to man to me. You're not a little boy anymore who was, you know, shit himself and, you know, and was scared of everything and needed to, you know, hang out with his mommy and sleep the same bed his mom and dad.
Thank you for having me, bro.
It was
a little different than I expected, but we'll see what comes of it. And, you know, I wish you the best of luck with everything.
I love you. You're one of my favorite people in the world, and the stuff that you did for me, I'm not gonna forget that one. Number one is my God. Number two, Bustamante. Then comes your family, and boy, do I love you, and really want to spend. I want to spend some time, and also I want you to talk about maybe if Eve have some friends or something like that. You know, we can go out to the club, go to the disco, we can, you know, have some alcohol.
Eve has lots of friends. I just, you know, don't know how comfortable she'd be introducing them to you.
Okay, well, we're gonna see. Maybe this one way to find out. Okay, porra! My brother, come here. My brother, oh, they come here from everywhere.
Thanks for having me, bro.
Yeah, you're welcome. Okay, get on. Get you on the what? Come on. Wait, stand up straight. Now you're the one who's gonna get through me up in the back. Alright. Okay. You learned a lot, I taught you well. The student had become the master. Okay, hey. Okay. Dispatch.
Porra. We did it, fella. Another one on the books. Wow. We had some fun today. Also, we had some moments where we wanted to smack Hannah on the chops because he was said some disrespectful stuff. But he might hook us up with his sister or maybe some of the other cousins that you have. So I'm grateful for that. We both gonna get a lot of punchang this year. I know that in my heart. In my heart of heart, I know we're gonna get a lot of pussy. I love you, Fera. Good night.